groomsman William escorting Maggie and Kaya. Next, we have Emma and Kyle. Following them is Vasudha and Yushin. Following them is Melody and Maddie. And next we have Fred and Tom. And now, ladies and gentlemen, join me in welcoming Mr. and Mrs. Michael and Avery Chen. And now, ladies and gentlemen, they will share their first dance as husband and wife.
Can't explain all the feelings that you're making me feel. My heart's in overdrive and you're behind the steering wheel. Touching you, touching me, touching you, are you touching me? I believe in a thing called love, just listen to the rhythm of my heart. There's a chance we can make it now, we'll be rocking till the sun goes down. I believe in a thing called love.
Yeah.
I'd like to invite Avery's father to join her on the dance floor.
So today, as Kevin said, this really is the culmination and answer to a literal lifetime of prayers that we've prayed for Avery and for the husband that God would provide for her. And here she is. You know, if you'd asked me to script out kind of who is the type of man that I would want to pick for my daughter, you know, my list would have been thoughtful, kind, devoted, willing to care and love and serve her, even at the expense of self. And a follower of Jesus, and here he is. I and Maggie mentioned this last night. I was impressed with Michael before I even met the guy, for a number of reasons. So first, on their very first date, you know, Avery and Michael met on an app, and they had a few video kind of calls, and then Michael had suggested they go meet at a local park in Richmond. And Avery, freaking out is probably too strong, but she was feeling a lot of pressure, you know, like, and I think some for us, for our kids, right, Jen and I have been together since we were, you know, teenagers, and so I think our kids have felt some pressure, like, every date, like, is this the one? There's this pressure. So in an attempt to be lighthearted, to try to remove that pressure, I tried to tell Avery, you know, look, you don't need to figure that out. I mean, the literally only thing you need to figure out to go on this first date is the guy a Nazi? That is literally the only thing, like, no other pressure. And so that seemed to take the pressure off, and she went on the date, and indeed, Michael was not a Nazi. So, so we checked that box, and we could proceed to level two. The next thing I remember, I think it was their second date, I think Michael made homemade soybean pudding, was that right? And I thought, you know, for a second date, I mean, I never did anything like that. I was like, what a super thoughtful thing that was. And as I've gotten to know Michael, you know, more directly over the last 6 to 8 months, I would say thoughtfulness is one of Michael's chief defining characteristics, which is just awesome. Probably the next thing that I remember, and again, I've probably met Michael at this point, but haven't interacted with him a ton. The next thing I heard that impressed me was, and this is right after Michael and Avery got back together. I think Avery and some of her friends who were here had gone on a road trip to Kaya's wedding. And I guess you guys went on a hike in the middle of who knows where, Alabama, and apparently were so far out in the forest, or this place is so remote, they were off the grid, and so their cell phones weren't working. And so Avery neglected to check in when she was supposed to. And as far as we know, Michael is not biologically related to the Imbert side of the family. So he is not genetically predisposed to excessive fear and worry. If you're an Imbert, you know what I'm talking about. Nevertheless, Michael was sufficiently concerned that he eventually called like the local police and I think even the forestry department to like find the guy who's in charge of this place. Like, and so eventually Avery got back in range. It's all good, but I remember thinking as a dad, and I kind of found this out after the fact, I'm like, you know, if I'm going to entrust my daughter to somebody who's going to worry about her exactly as much as I would in that situation, I'm liking what I'm hearing. And then just over the last several months, even again before I really got to spend much time with Michael, I mean, almost every time Avery is interacting with Michael, you know, I mean, if you're a parent, you know how you can tell when your kids are really laughing. Like sometimes they're laughing, but you can tell when something really captures their heart, and the level of laughter that I've heard, can't look at you, from Avery, I can tell that there's just an absolute joyous laughter that she shares when she's with Michael, and that was telling to me. And then the last thing that I'll say about Michael is, and it happened again tonight, so Michael and Avery, they go to our church, and after they got back together, the number of guys at our church, guys my age or older, people I know and respect, would come up totally unsolicited to me and go, hey, you know, just gotten to know Michael a little bit at Second Monday or church breakfast, whatever. Great guy, just a great guy. And in fact, one of those guys here tonight, I was before, and this is literally 20 minutes ago, said, Michael is the most passionate follower of Jesus that I have met in a long time. So I'm a huge Michael fan. And I am... And so going back to my, you know, Michael's thoughtful, kind, devoted. I have absolute confidence that you will love and care for Avery, even at the expense of self, and you're a follower of Jesus. So Jen and I could not be more happy to entrust our daughter to you and you to her and to welcome you into our family. So Avery, I've been weaving around this. Avery, I love you. You are the best daughter any man could ever hope to have. You are brave, you are fearless, you are compassionate. Your character is just tremendous, and I could not be more proud to be your dad, and not because of the accomplishments that you've had or the accomplishments that you're gonna have that will be even more extraordinary than anything you've done yet. I just love you because of your character and who you are. And I'm just so glad to be your dad, and I'm glad to hand you off to Michael and for us to join our families together. So with that, to the bride and groom.
Hi everyone, I'm Fred and I'm very honored to, very honored to be a maid of honor here alongside Melody. Avery and I first met in college in 2015 as freshmen, and we did not instantly become best friends. Here is this woman who is always well-dressed, even at 7 a.m. when she wakes up, even when there's no class, and knows way more Chinese than me, both the language and the history. Very intimidating. You are wildly put together, and I was so scared of you. But it does not take long to see more sides of Avery, her kindness, her boldness, and her fun. Fast forward a couple months, we were on a trip together in a ballroom competition, and we are on the plane, sat next to each other, discussing the team drama that was going on. We're freshmen in ballroom. There's a lot of love and a lot of unrequited love. And so we're sitting there discussing who's unrequiting whom, and drawing a diagram on those airplane napkins. And then the plane's about to land, and we have this napkin with all the gossip of all the teammates who are also on the plane. And I look at Avery and I say, "Avery, no one can see this napkin." And she says, "Agreed." So she rips it up, and together we eat it. Yes, we ate the whole napkin. And it's very hard not to want to be someone's best friend when you eat a napkin of gossip together. And so that's where we are now. So that's the fun side of Avery. Another side of Avery that I want to talk about is her bravery and boldness. As mentioned, we're in ballroom together for all 4 years, and one major obstacle in collegiate ballroom is, what do you do if you don't have a partner, right? A lot of people quit. A lot of people get discouraged, and when everyone is in pairs practicing, they don't want to practice by themselves, and so they eventually leave. But not Avery. Avery forged ahead where no one did before, and don't get me wrong, she was really grumpy the whole time she didn't have a partner. But Avery being grumpy about something and Avery quitting something are two very different things. And you have taught me that through struggle, you can actively struggle with it and still forge ahead and refuse to quit. And it is because of Avery that there are dozens and dozens of girls who got to dance when they didn't have partners. And so Avery, your bravery and your courage has impacted those around you, but also those who don't even know you later down the line. You forged the path for them. And they have what they have because of you. And of course, this goes without saying, but Avery is the best friend anyone could want. She is so caring and nurturing, in addition to being so fun and so bold. I can't remember the number of times she's brought me a well-timed coffee during exam week, or left a handwritten note in front of my door in college, or just been there to listen. She deserves the bestest, mostest love possible, and seeing her get married to Michael makes me feel very fangxing, which is a Chinese phrase for saying your heart is at peace, your heart can be put down, because you know that this is in good hands. I first met Michael through Zoom, playing Catan with Avery. And he, like many have mentioned already, immediately struck me as someone so kind, caring, and funny, and a loving partner. And we didn't actually meet in person until over a year later, this August. And I have to say, the 4D experience of Michael's kindness is just truly unparalleled. So Michael, your wife is such an incredible bright light to the world. She is so nurturing, hilarious, and brave. And will be there through thick and thin with you, as I'm sure you will be for her. I am so lucky to be her friend, and man, you are so lucky to be her husband. That was a real big brain move to marry her. please love Avery well and nurture her, just as she has nurtured everyone else around her thus far. And I so clearly see the joy that you guys have when you're with each other, and I wish you all the best.
Hi everyone, I'm Tom Buchanan, Michael's best man, and it's an honor to be up here tonight to speak about somebody I care so much about. He's truly a great friend, and I do want to thank the Simmons and Chen family. I really appreciate you guys putting all of this together. You did a great job. Um, So I met Michael about 4 years ago in our economics class at the MBA program at the University of Richmond. And my first impression was that he was pretty reserved, but that he was extremely intelligent. And you can tell every word that comes out of his mouth is very meticulous and very thoughtful. We worked on pretty much every project together throughout the entire program with Abigail. Shout out to you. And I could tell you were somebody that I looked up to right away. And it's amazing how smart Michael is. And even more important than that, something I learned about Michael very, very early is how much he cares about other people. And we heard from a lot of friends and family last night about how Michael would travel across the country and hang out with people, and he keeps in touch. He truly does care about his friends and his family. And if everyone in the world were more like Michael, the world would be a much better place. There were many times after class, it's, 10 o'clock at night, we're going to a part-time program, and Michael would stay around and talk. He's willing to listen to you. He's the type of person you put on your emergency contact list, and he'll show up, even if he doesn't know he's on your emergency contact list. And he's just willing to hear you out, any problems you're having, he's willing to talk you through them. And it's something I really, truly admire about you, Michael. And Avery, it's been so nice getting to know you, and I can tell that you share all the same qualities that Michael has and how much you guys love each other. Your love really is infectious, and I wish you both a long, happy, and fulfilling marriage together. So thank you for having me here. It's truly an honor to be able to speak in front of all friends and family, and for you too, and how amazing this couple and marriage is and will be. So thank you.
Okay, this blesses me. Father in heaven, thank you so much for this beautiful, beautiful day, for the sun, and for all these people who have come so far, traveled so far to be here with Michael and with Avery to celebrate the union and the love that you've given them. We thank you for bringing Michael and Avery together in the way that you have, in the impossible way that only you could have done, Lord, because you are God, and you know the desires of Michael and Avery beyond anyone else, beyond even themselves. And so today, as we continue to celebrate, I pray that you just bless this food, bless this time together, bless all the conversation, Lord, and let your love flow and pour over all these people over here. Let them all come to know who you are and see your glory and know that they are loved and they are beautiful and they're never alone. And so that's all. And in Jesus' name, pray. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Everybody,
please make your way outside. Thank you.